Glory and honor be to the name of the Lord for another wonderful episode of Come Let's Discuss the Bible. Today with me I have my daddy with me, the person of Pastor Matthew Orimoloye. Daddy, you're welcome, sir.
Thank you, sir.
And also you viewers, we thank you for watching our programs, and I pray that the Lord Jesus Christ will always bless every one of us in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Today we have another special topic here we want to talk about, and the topic is anger. I don't know over there whether you have something of such inside of you, and it's not something good at all for any believer. It is very, very bad. But we just want to say something about it, so that you too over there and we over yourself can learn from whatever we say today, whatever the Holy Spirit will give unto us to say today. We want to learn from it, and want you also to learn from it, so that we can be blessed together.
Yeah. Daddy, we want to talk about anger.
What is anger?
Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Anger, you say, is a state of being annoyed or being displeased with what has happened. And so the person is now expressing his reaction in a high, in a state or in a situation that is not conformable to a normal human way of life.
Praise the Lord. What could cause anger? What could cause anger, sir?
Like I said earlier, the actions of a man can lead to anger. Like the action of committing fornication with him. His father's wife, bringing up on the by Reuben, also provoke the father to issue or make the father to be angry to issue cause against him. Then, apart from that, as we do it to man, we can also provoke God to anger in the sense that when God has given us the basic thing to do or warned us about what not to do, what not to do, and if a man goes into that realm and then thinking and say, we have to do nothing, we have to do.
I'm begging for him.
So I'm begging you, pray for me. If you go through the Bible, the book of Genesis, let's look at the book of Genesis, chapter 49, verse 1. Jacob called unto his sons and said, gather yourselves together that I may tell you that we shall before you in the last days. Gather yourselves together and hear ye, sons of Jacob. And I came unto Israel your father, Reuben, thou art my firstborn, my mind, and the beginning of my strength, and the excellence of dignity, and the excellency of power, was stable as water, thou shalt not excel, because thou wentest up to thy father's bed. And that's a very serious thing concerning Reuben, that one can be found in the book of Genesis, chapter 35. Verse 22, where Reuben went to have an affair with his father's wife. And so, of course, here is a curse going from the book of Leviticus. So, in the book of Genesis 35, verse 22, and it came to pass, when Israel dwelt in that land, that Reuben went and lay with Bilhah, his father's concubine, and Israel had it. Now the sons of Jacob were 12. So, at that time, Jacob had it, he did not say anything. But when it was time for him to go, to leave the house, he brought the anger of his mother upon him to injure the cause of non-achievement upon him. Not until when Moses came in the book of Deuteronomy, that Moses had to pray and say, Lord, let no Reuben be few. Meaning that the cause place of Reuben because of the anger of anger, brought a reduction in the total population of the children of Reuben. And then if you look at it critically in the Bible, you discover that the total population of the children of Reuben was very few. Mm. When a man does something that is contrary to the desire of his parent, to his father, any of the leader of the two, it can give rise to anger. Provocation can come at the same time, maybe from God's side, when a man provoke God in committing sin. And the Bible tells us about the angel in the book of Hebrews that presumptuous sin, when a man commits sin deliberately, after doing it, I will come back to repent. In fact, it is an act of provocation. And if a man goes into that realm and then thinking and say, we have to do nothing, we have.
I'm begging for him.
So I'm begging you, pray for me. So definitely, that is what the Bible refers to as presumptuous sin. And presumptuous sin can provoke anger. And when God pronounces his sentence, his judgment,
I don't know who can.
So there are so many things that we can talk about. When it comes to anger, anger is a very terrible thing. Anger is a spirit of the soul. There are some people that say, well, when the thing of my fathers has come upon me, they will be shaking from head to the toe. And so it will mean, therefore, that anger, again, has a spiritual connection, a spiritual pattern. So anger is a spirit of the soul. So we need to deal with all those things. So there are lots of so many things that can lead to anger, that can bring anger to us.